Rapper Vado issued a half apology after a clip of him attacking his girlfriend, reality star Tahiry, on WeTV's Marriage Bootcamp Hip Hop Edition. It went viral, y'all. He said he lost control after continuously being disrespected by Tahiry. Now, she did say some things about him. He went on to say, "I apologize to all women once again, but ladies, please keep y'all's hands to y'all selves. Hashtag us too." So he apologized.
Wait a minute. He said, "Ladies, keep your hands to yourself." He attacked her.
Well, I guess she had some little, you know, she tapped him up.
I guess she had attacked him before, and he was fed up and was like, "This ain't happening no more."
Ladies, we have a clip.
Let's, happen.
Let's check out the clip, and let's all speak on it after we look at this clip.
Okay.
And then I look crazy to y'all. I look extra aggressive.
Yo, you look on. Yo, like, for real, my
hands on
you, yo.
No.
Bugging out.
No.
Like, you lucky on.
Are you kidding me?
This house is on fire.
Now, if you notice, ladies, not one of the men in the group tried to stop Vado from attacking Tahiry. Is the lack of protection when it comes to Black women, is this just normal now? Is that what we're doing? These men did not do anything.
I don't think that it's normal. I do think there, and I have seen instances where Black men are to the rescue for Black women.
Yeah.
And I was on Marriage Bootcamp before, so I know like how the infrastructure of that show kind of runs, and it is very, very, they perpetuate scenarios so that it can look a certain way. Now, I'm not saying what he did was good, because you shouldn't have got up and put your hands on, you should have walked off. But we didn't see that, it didn't show at all that she hit him. But then he says that she hit him. So why did production not show the full thing? And then you have to ask yourself, did they not show men getting up? Did they not, you know what I'm saying? So right. It's hard to kind of make a statement about what really went on there, because it's so, you can tell the editing is so clip. But if that is the case, they are off the chain, and somebody should have jumped up. That's outrageous. But I don't put that on all Black men, because there are Black men. Because had that been Kiwan Garris, it would have been slow singing and flower bringing. So I do know men that will whoop somebody's ass and not allow that. Like, my husband wouldn't have sat there and watched him do none of that. Like, he would have jumped up quick. So
was the one guy that did jump up that said no? That was just a bouncer.
He was the host. He was like one of the hosts.
Oh, okay. So wow, really? Okay, well, that was good that the host would put his, you know, mug on.
He's a Black man.
We are so in a place that we're afraid to do any and everything now. You're afraid to get involved. You're afraid to get violent. You're afraid not to do nothing. You don't want to be sued. It's so much that goes on that you can be stuck. Like, I'm here for the whole commentary of even when he said, ladies, keep your hands to yourself. Men, keep your hands to yourself. Nobody should be exchanging stuff. But then I can also understand that sometimes a bitch need to be shook the shit out of, you know, just every now and then, you know what I mean? Like, hey.
No. No.
We call on that, because that's what Chris Rock said.
Let me say this.
No matter what, a weapon, if you got a weapon, she didn't have a weapon. But listen, if a woman.
I'm not saying in this circumstance, I'm saying, you know, that there's some women that got mouth that make you just want to smack the out of them, period. And I mean that sometimes you just want to take somebody and shake the out of them.
Yeah. But the mouth ain't good enough, Lisa Ray. They got.
You know what, Wani?
Everybody's talking to me crazy. I'm telling you that.
Oh, no,
right
as
now.
A girl, no, bad.
Not a guy either. Like, I'm not, especially if I'm not bringing that to you. I have very thin patience for that. Like, for real.
Have any of y'all ever been hit by a man?
Yeah.
I've been in fights.
And I'm still here to tell it.
I got in a tussle.
I've been in fights.
Oh, wow. Really,
you know when something's about to start. We've seen on Love and Hip Hop where the girl done walked across the table and the girl was in the chair and it was almost like, well, what was you waiting on when she was walking across the table? Yeah. Like, what were you thinking?
What were you waiting
on? I would have been up when she was up. You know what I mean? I don't even like nobody talk to me when I'm sitting down and they standing up. It's like,
I don't like that either.
The same. Yeah.
I immediately stand real quick.
Yeah.
So I immediately stand up if somebody's over me talking. I immediately stand up. That's like a knee jerk. But yeah. I've been in fights with men because I don't condone it, but you're not, if you hit me, we're in a fight. There is no, there's none of that.
Well, I have
to squaring up like this. You're going to have to fight me unless you're big.
I'm going to wait till your ass go to sleep and then I'm going to shoot you.
Then my people going to come after you.
Al Green had that. Remember the girl with the grits? She went wait till he went to sleep and got them grits on.
Got him get with the grits, right? We have to realize as women, men are stronger than us. So watch throwing them, squaring up.
No, we gonna square up. You gonna have to knock me out.
No, Selena, no. Because
if you hit me, I'm not gonna chill. We're going to fight. Because I don't know what else you're gonna do.
I've actually been knocked out by a man before. So, like, I'm appalled at some of this conversation right now. It's really triggering me right now in a way.
I'm telling you, Claudia, though, if he knocked you out, you should have waited for his ass to go to sleep and got
it. I wasn't dating him. He's someone I rejected, and he saw me out, and he snatched me by my arm and pulled me super hard. And I turned around, and I slapped him, actually. I slapped him. He pushed me so hard that I fell, and then I slapped him. And he punched me so hard, I don't remember being knocked out.
Dang.
I got up. And I don't remember, and I didn't feel any pain. The next day, I got up, and I had to go to the emergency room to check for cracked teeth and have an x-ray. That was my first concussion. I was 21 years old. Yes, women can be mouthy. We can get out of control. We can turn down men. But when we start giving them passes to when they can or cannot fuck us up, they will take them. Women, do not hit a man. And men, you are stronger than us. Even if I did hit you, you could probably snatch my hands up so easy and stop me. And this guy put his whole back into it. I had a f***ed up memory for a long time because of that. And Tahiry said a lot of disrespectful shit on that show. She really did. And she just
I'm sorry you went through that, and I didn't
realize.
I don't know what he went through, but I am I stand by what I said. Ladies, keep your hands to yourself, and men, keep your hands to yourself.
Yes, but it's also not a fair fight when we do fight. It's not.
It's not a fair fight.
The strongest woman can ever fight.
You're dealing with. There's some men out there that you can whoop that because I hadn't had a couple. I didn't fuck them up.
And I don't. And it's not a fair fight. But I have been in predicaments where if you allow them to, you know, I've been in a predicament where he was being aggressive and hitting me and choking me I was trying to stay calm, and what happens is, they'll keep going because they're bullies. So they'll keep going all the time. But if you for me, in my predicament, I had to tag his ass real, real good. And
I have
to let him know.
Well, you know what I mean?
I'm going to fight you back.
You know, 6'5" and try to, you know what I mean, square up with him. You're going to have to wait until he go to sleep like Vivica said. And you have a
strategy. But if you are hitting me, I'm going to defend myself.
I get that.
I'm not going to stay with you. Now, that's the thing. I'm not going to stay there and allow you to keep whooping my ass. But if you try to fight me, I'm going to defend myself. I don't give a shit how big you are. It is what it is. If you was going to kill me, you was going to kill me anyway.
Yes. We got to take a quick break. I don't know if we have time to finish this conversation when we get back. But I'm glad we had this conversation because it does. Listen, we don't all have to be on the same page. That's why there's four women on the show and not one. So we need to have these conversations because there's gonna be people in the comments that's like, hell yeah, Lisa Ray, or hell yeah, Claudia, or no.
None of that.
But welcome back to Cocktails with the Queens. We just had a heated conversation about
hands.
Men and women fighting.
And
real quick, I don't mean if a man hits you, you ain't supposed to defend yourself. You're supposed to shoot him if he does that. I mean,
oh my God.
If a man lets a woman's words get him to the point, you popping up at the mouth and you getting hit, I don't believe in that. And that's where I say, and I don't care what you say to a man, he's strong and he can get them hands together and calm your ass down. Yes. A word should never be met with some hits.
He should have never choked her out at all. Like, and she you could tell she was not, she wasn't, you know, prepared for that. She didn't know that was coming. You know, I mean, it was like a, but some things happen so quick. Sometimes you have an out of body experience and you just flip out and just pass out.
I believe how she was talking to him, she should have got broken up with by talking about how he the brokest guy she'd ever been with. That was very disrespectful to be on
TV. That was horrible.
Very.
And she should have been left. I would have broke up with her if I was him.
I would have left the whole house.